Hello, hello, and welcome to Art Lounge Alley, everyone. This is Figure Drawing Basics, part 54. Welcome to the evening stream. Today's Labor Day, and what better day to stream the labor of love? This is my love right here. So I'm happy to share this moment with you guys on a day where everybody's relaxing, taking their time to enjoy themselves. For those of you tuning in, welcome as always. And I will start today's stream in just a minute after I introduce newcomers to the Patreon page. There are a couple of tiers here that are pretty interesting that I would like you guys to check out. So without further ado, here it is. This is the Art Lounge Alley Patreon page. We got 6 tiers altogether. Pretty cool ones coming up. But first, we got tier 1, official patron, $2 per month. The most affordable tier out of the 6, which grants you access to the Discord server. Basically a chat room for everybody to come to, hang out, get to know one another, share interesting content, express yourself, share your ideas and thoughts, that sort of thing. And it brings everybody together from all the social media platforms that I post to regularly, as well as all the different tiers. You guys can all hang out in one room, as well as having your patron name listed in the credits. Once you guys start pledging, I'm going to start doing credits at the end of the stream as a way to say thank you for keeping our Lounge Alley going and showing your support, and as well as being part of the patron-only community. Next, we got tier 2, all-access patrons, $5 per month. This one, you get all the previous tiers, plus having early access to finished pages and exclusive content. So whatever it is that I'm going to finish, any of the projects, any of the work that you guys see, or even stuff that you won't see, is going to be on the Patreon page, and you guys will have early access to check those out, as well as exclusive content, meaning only on Patreon are you going to be able to see it. So those of you who pledge to this tier, you guys are going to have access to that. You're going to see what's going on. You also get access to work in progress, which is things like speed painting processes, like I upload some speed painting videos showing you guys from beginning to end as much as possible. I sometimes do stuff offline, but I am starting to record that time as well. Just to show you guys what that process is, what the final product, where it came from, how the whole journey was. And I find that to be really interesting. Hopefully you guys do too. And of course, as I mentioned, all the previous tier benefits as well. Then we got tier 2. This is where it gets interesting. This is where you guys get to be part of the Art Lounge Alley stream. So $15 per month allows you guys to submit work to be critiqued live on stream. And that's going to be held every Friday from 8 until 10 p.m. I'm going to be doing critiques. So once you guys submit your work through the Discord server, which you will have access to once you pledge to this tier, I will start doing the critique, and as well as promoting your social media. So if you got more work cooking on your platform, make sure to include that, and I'll make that visible to all the viewers. There's some things to read through, not that much for this one. Next, we got Kickstarter patrons, $25 per month. Another cool one where I will be doing a high resolution digital painting of you for being a Kickstarter of the Patreon page. So I encourage you guys to wear masks, makeup, glasses, make expressive face expressions, wear hats and accessories. Those just make the portrait more fun. It makes the stream more fun. It gives you guys the opportunity to be as creative as you'd like, but it's not necessary. You could just send me a photo of yourself from your head down to your neck, and I will do a live digital painting of you. And once that's complete, I'm going to send it to you, and you could do whatever you'd like. Make it your social media profile, send it to a loved one. The options are limitless. Next, we got tier 4, artist promotion. This is another one that's really cool, and I'm really looking forward to you guys submitting. $25 per month. You could do it only once. You know, if you just want to submit once for promotion, that's totally fine. Just make sure you cancel before the next month starts. I still gonna research and see if it's optional for you to just have that as a one-time submission thing. But yeah, until then, you guys can just cancel after you submit before the next month starts, so that way you're not charged again. This is meant for intermediate or advanced artists. It's an opportunity for you guys to promote your work, to showcase what you got, bring in more followers, bring in more viewers, and just be part of the Art Lounge Alley stream community. Be a regular, hopefully. So for this, you get 5 minute airtime at the beginning of the stream. I'm going to introduce you guys. I'm also going to promote you on all the social media platforms prior to the stream starting. That way you guys get more traction, get more attention. And I will also play a 5 minute video that's required for this tier to showcase your work. The reason is it allows you guys to be as expressive as you'd like in showing your work, in talking about your work, or performing your work, or whatever it is. This tier is open to all sorts of artists. It's not just for illustrators. So if you know somebody who is either a comedian, a dancer, a musician, architect, an animator, painter, poet, performance artist, filmmaker, or just an artist with interesting content, let them know about the Art Lounge Alley stream. Tell them that they have an opportunity to promote their work on here and get more viewers. There are some important things on here. There's some tips, there's some ideas for all the different artists here, and you guys are always welcome to ask me questions. I'll be happy to answer them online or offline. Just send it away in chat or DM me, and I'll be glad to answer that question. Next, we got tier 5 private tutoring, limited to 15 people, $65 per month. Get 4 personalized videos per month, 1 video per week, demonstrating where you could improve, what you could do. I also assign you homework so you could improve even faster. I give you like step-by-step instructions and visual demonstration, meaning I show you in Clip Studio Paint over what you submitted, what you could do to make it look better, that sort of thing. And I will also send you the PSD file that I'm going to be working on, so you could explore it at your own pace. You can copy it, whatever it is that you like to do with it. It's going to be yours to keep. You'll also get a private Discord channel that gives us an opportunity to interact with one another. Nobody else gets to see it. It's private, you know, so showcase your mistakes, whatever it is. It doesn't matter. The entire point of it is going to be to help you improve, to get you to be better. So you don't have to worry about other people seeing it. It's going to be between me and you. You can leave me comments, you can leave me questions, you can leave me the progress, and I'll write you back or talk about it in the next video. There are other benefits there as well, and as I mentioned, you guys can check this out. This is on the Patreon page, not the Patreon page, this is on the Twitch channel. You can go and check it out in the about section, along with other social media platforms, and just take your time and read through it at your own pace. And as I mentioned, if you got questions or if you got comments or whatever it is, send them away. I'll be happy to read them. All right, y'all, that pretty much does it. Let's jump into today's stream. There you go. So we're gonna continue where I left off last week. Gonna be doing more head examples, gonna be filling out this page. And yes, this isn't well, no, really, this isn't the new sketchbook. This is an old sketchbook of mine. This is where my motivation came from to fill up pages as much as possible. You know, I was looking through just like over the years where things have gone and how I kind of use the sketchbooks. Hold on a second, y'all. Sorry about that, everyone. I keep forgetting to turn on the AC. This section of the apartment gets kind of hot. I think it has to do something with the computer and the fans of the computer and all that other stuff. Anyways, I was just looking at my old sketchbooks and I was like, man, I really wasted a lot of paper. Like, I didn't spend any time on each page. If something didn't look right, if I didn't like it, I just skipped the page. Like, I drew something over here and then it didn't turn out good and I just moved on to the next page. Part of it had to do with this idea of like scrapping it, right? Like just saying, forget it. Let's just start it fresh. And in some ways that's great. But in other ways it becomes a habit if you don't keep an eye out for it, and it becomes like an scapegoat, like rather than really pushing through it and being like, well, what's wrong with it? You know, what can I do to actually to improve it? I would out skip it and just move on to the next page. So it started out as something that I thought would be beneficial and turned into a bad habit. It's kind of like it's important to keep all these different ideas in mind. You know, that's the beauty of like art in general. Like it just makes you think. It really does. It makes you, like, if you really are set on becoming really good, really improving your skill, it is a thinking process. You do have to take into account all these different things. You know, remembering, for instance, to draw lightly. Remembering not to press too hard on the paper and not giving the pencil a death grip and having it all the way close to the tip. You know, that kind of makes it a very rigid experience. It also obstructs your vision. Like when you're holding it this close, right? Like you could see that the range of motion is very limited, whereas this is a lot more free feeling and free flowing. It doesn't feel as stiff and rigid. And it kind of helps, you know, just developing that sensitivity to lines, the kind of lines that you make. And it really ends up being very beneficial for you, especially in the beginning, the most crucial part of the drawing. You know, the structure that you lay down is going to be pretty much the foundation for everything going forward, right? So you want to make sure that foundation is solid. You know, the same way when you are building a building, you don't want to make, you don't want the foundation to be shaky and then have the entire building collapse on itself when you're like decorating everything and, you know, putting up the windows and doors and all that stuff. So the same idea comes to when it comes to drawing. You want to make sure that that foundation is solid. Getting in the habit of drawing lightly allows you to do what I just did right now, which is, if it looks bad, you have a chance to erase it, and it's not going to be this like permanent mark that you're stuck with for the rest of the drawing, which is sometimes also the reason why I would skip the page. I'm like, it's just too ingrained. You know, it brings up a good point. Like, there were times where I pressed way too hard in the beginning, or worked way too much on a detail in the beginning, and then found out that it just doesn't look right proportionally, anatomically, and erasing it would just smear it everywhere, or just not erase it. You know, just like stick around or just be stuck on the paper. So I'll just move on to a new page, a new fresh page. It's a bit of a warm-up. I want to try it again, because I don't think I got it right. And what I didn't get right is the angle. And that's a really important thing. Another thing that's really important to keep in mind is like paying attention to the angle. If you're working from a subject, you know, whether it's still life or a person, it's a really important detail. It could change a face expression. It could change the mood or the body language if you don't pay attention, or it could really ruin your image by, for instance, when people spend a lot of time putting in detail, you know, they put in the proportion of the body and so on and so forth, and then at some point they realize that the entire figure is angled wrong. It's like tilted, so the figure looks like it's about to topple over, and that's a huge disappointment. You know, you kind of want to avoid that, so making sure that you get the angle of the body down is a really important step. A really important step in making sure your drawing looks good. Little bit better, but notice that everything is kind of parallel. You got the tip of the nose, it's parallel to the direction of the eyes and the eyebrows. You got the mouth generally in that direction as well. So aside from proportion, aside from placement of face features, there's this aspect as well, getting down the angle. And these lines right here just give you more understanding of the three dimensions of the facial features. A big difference here, as you can see. While this is another way of or another angle rather, of drawing the face. The challenge here was to make sure everything kind of lined up with the direction. And I'll draw these lines just to demonstrate. Eyebrows are parallel to the eyes. Directions of eyes are the angle, rather. Angle of the eyes, the angle of the eyebrows are parallel. The angle of the nose, or the tip of the nose, is parallel to the ones above. And the mouth as well. Next, there is another angle. Oh, by the way, I forgot to mention that there is something brewing for a special stream. I'm working on it. I'm hoping that I can air it this week. There's quite a lot. It's a great book. It's a book that I've had for a while. And as I mentioned, I've just been looking through some stuff. I've been looking through books, textbooks that I've had, sketchbooks that I've had. And I came across that book and I was like, oh, wow, this is great work that I would be excited to talk about on stream and excited to introduce you guys to. This book has lots of artists there. You know, this is something that is more on the old school side, but very important artist, very important era as well for illustration. So just a really important part in history of illustration as well, as far as like American illustration goes. It sheds light on a lot of things that happened in a time period. So there's some history there, some really interesting stuff that it highlights, and how it influenced people's fashion, how it influenced people's perception of beauty. So I'm really excited to bring that up. There's a lot there, you know, in the few pages in the book, which primarily is drawings and illustrations, beautiful drawings and illustrations. In fact, I really can't wait for you guys to see them. There's a lot of history there as well. I mean, there isn't that much text, let's just say, in the book. I would say it's only like a third of the book, not even. Of just text, and then everything else is just illustrations. But yeah, so as I mentioned, really, really important stuff happening in that time period for illustration in general, and I think comics as well. I mean, it really touches up on how technology really did help at the time. Illustrators and what a boom it was for illustration at that period. So yeah, it's going to be a fun stream. I'm going to be showing lots of different artists, because there are lots of artists, and I'm not even sure if I could cover all of them. I mean, it would almost seem as if, though, if I really spend time on developing this stream, there would be lots of illustrators to show, because they're all connected. You know, they're all, and that's what I was surprised to read about. You know, as I was reading. To see what kind of material that I should mention, I was surprised to see how many that I actually really admire myself influenced each other, and how they were just like part of that era altogether. You know, it's kind of like that Alex Raymond scenario where I walked into the comic book shop, I saw the book, Flash Gordon, I really liked the art, and I had no idea that Alex Raymond also influenced John Buscema. For those of you who are part of the Drawing Comics stream, you guys know how much, in fact, even now, you could see in the background, this is all John Buscema's work. But yeah, it was just this, like, delightful surprise knowing that they're connected. And the same thing happened with this. It was kind of like just a coincidence that I got this book. And it also mentioned a lot of illustrators that I really like and admire myself. At the time that I did get this book, I didn't really pay attention to the text. It was more about the work that's in there. But now reading about it, I discovered all this like cool information. I gotta say, one of the things that I really love about streaming is that it really pushes me to sit down and draw. And in that process, I'm always reminded of how much I really do enjoy illustration, how much I draw, how much I love drawing. You know, it really does push for that to happen. You know, I think that is one of the most challenging parts, and it's always been kind of, I don't know about you guys or other artists who are watching this, but sitting down and doing it is probably the biggest challenge, because once I'm past that state, it becomes a thing where I just, I spend lots of hours, and I remind myself, like, oh, this is all a lot of fun, this is such a cool experience, so on and so forth. So there's definitely a perk to it, and I also get to share all these cool things with you guys. But yeah, projects, project, and some sort of long-term goals really help with motivation. You know, if you're just sitting down just to draw for the sake of drawing, in order to get you there, it's helpful to set yourself some goals. Like incremental goals. It doesn't have to be streaming if you're not into that. It doesn't have to be a huge project or anything like that. It could be things like, this entire week I'm going to practice how to draw hands. So when you sit down, you're just like, okay, that's exactly what I'm going to do. You wake up the next day, you know exactly what you have to do. And try to achieve that goal. And setting those little incremental goals can get you in a habit of sitting down to draw. Like now for me, if I take time to not draw for whatever reason, like if I'm sick or something, I still feel like I should be drawing. It's just this this desire that starts to pop up every day. But prior to having these kind of goals, it was kind of like maybe today, maybe tomorrow, you know, other things would start to take some sort of priority. But the same thing is with like comics, where when I was doing comics, I was drawing comics, I needed to pump out issues, and that was a motivating factor. Not only because I had to do it, but because the story itself, or having to see it all come alive and having the characters come alive and like creating a really cool panel. You know, these are all goals that start to manifest themselves from that project. And it really helped with motivation. It really helped with consistency as well. So what I'm getting at is just the idea of little goals really go a long way until you eventually work yourself up to having bigger goals. They're great motivators and great form of direction. And again, that idea of just do it comes into play. Like when you know you're supposed to sit down and draw, don't even rationalize it in your head. Don't even think about like, well, I should do this, I should do that, or whatever. Make it a priority and just sit down and do it. Just do it. Don't come up with any sort of dialogue in your head. Just automatically kind of sit down and do it. And once you get there, once you get to the habit of doing that, you'll be grateful to yourself. You'll be like, great, I have discipline. You know, I'm pushing myself to do this every day. And you'll be proud of yourself. And you'll also feel good that you're practicing, that you're drawing on a daily basis. So multiple benefits. This is also a really cool shot, a really cool angle, not a common one. But refreshing. notice how the top of the brow is the guide to the top of the ear, and then the bottom of the nose is the guide for the bottom of the ear. So once again, the angle is really important, and these lines really help achieve that. I'm really liking this channel. It's my new favorite channel from Pretzel. It's called Chill Hop. For those of you wondering, do I miss the Sprite music? Maybe just a tiny bit. It was funny. It is a different mood as well. But I'm liking this a lot. And for those of you who miss it, I will surely come back to that at some point in the future. And these guidelines play a really important role because they really help understand the face three-dimensionally. Like, as you see that it curves, you kind of understand that this section right here is like another plane, rather. Like, this section is another plane. This is the section where it starts to curve inwards more or round. So just to walk you guys through my thought process as I'm doing this, as I mentioned, there are multiple ways of trying to achieve accuracy, right? And one of the ways that I've been teaching very frequently is the space relationship between objects. So for example, looking at the reference, the distance between the bottom of the nose and the lips, studying that and noticing, okay, well, it shouldn't be too far away from one another. That allows more accuracy, right? I could draw it in reference. But what I'm also trying to do as I'm drawing this, not only just to achieve accuracy, but is also to understand a three-dimensional placement of things. So I'm not trying to just copy what I'm seeing and make sure that it's as accurate as possible. I'm also trying to understand visually why things are drawn this way. What is it about it? If that makes sense. And it's a little bit difficult to explain because obviously it's kind of what we're doing. We're just trying to understand it. But there's a difference between drawing something and trying to achieve accuracy and drawing something and trying to understand its anatomy. Trying to understand its structure so that you could do it without having a reference and it looks right. You know, once you understand, well, because everything is angled upwards, you would see the bottom of, I want to say the chin, right? It's the bottom of the chin. So just having to construct the entire figure. Becomes a challenge, the next challenge. And as I mentioned, that's something that happens through repetition. Like if I draw this once, this angle once, and I nail it visually, it looks right, it doesn't necessarily mean from now on, I'm going to be drawing this face always accurately. Just like as I mentioned within a reading process, when you were first learning to read, if you just recited the alphabet one time, did it mean that you were able to read and understand everything from that point on? No, right? Most likely not. So it's the same idea here. Just because, let's say I drew this out and it looks right, doesn't mean that I'm going to draw it correctly each and every time. Probably not. You know, I have to draw it multiple times to really grasp why things are placed or drawn rather the way that they are. Understanding the relationships between all the facial features in this perspective to help construct it properly. Understanding the limitations of each facial feature in this angle. You know, because it's in this angle, how far out is the corner of the mouth supposed to go? What is the angle and line of, let's say, the bottom part of the bottom part lip? Or the bottom lip, to make it more simple. Yeah, it's like all these little things that really reveal themselves and kind of encrypt themselves in your memory the more you practice it. And I'm also making sure not to get too close to the tip of the pencil. And it's even so uncomfortable once I start going down there. That I'm little by little getting used to having the pencil held at a distance like this. It really does help me with the range of motion. But yeah, I encourage you guys to experiment with yourself. Pay attention to yourself when you're drawing and how you feel. For instance, when you are holding the pencil really close to the tip, and then practice drawing from a distance and just pay attention to how it feels to draw the lines, how your hand feels, how your fingers feel. Are you able to go from one side to the other with ease, as opposed to when you're holding it like this? What about in the sketching process, like when you're sketching out? Try both ways and see what the benefit is, one over the other. Time is flying, y'all. I didn't think the session would be this short. Probably has to do with the Patreon page launch intros, but I'm gonna be back. I'm gonna take a 5-minute break, get ready for the next stream, which is right behind me. It's gonna be drawing comics, and I'm gonna continue drawing John Buscema's Conan the Barbarian. For those of you who are just tuning in, I've been doing all the panels from the book. Also inking and coloring them using different techniques. First watercolor, then I did some with pencils, color pencils, which are somewhere ahead, starting here, as you could see. And then I moved on to doing what I'm excited to do tomorrow. Is it tomorrow? No, it's Wednesday. India inks. Beautiful results. Really fun process. And beautiful colors. I mean, you guys can see in comparisons, this color pencil, this is India inks, how smooth and rich those colors look in comparison. Not to say one is worse or so on. I still enjoyed color pencils. It's just a different experience. You know, having to use pencils as opposed to brushes and liquid form and all that. It's an experience on its own. And I will be coming back to color pencils. Don't get me wrong. I did enjoy it. I have this cool set that I like using. So Yeah, I'll be coming back to that. I'll be making that announcement as a special stream at some point. But yeah, this Wednesday is going to be more India Ink exploring, India Ink inking, coloring. So make sure you tune in. Tune in this Wednesday. Tomorrow is going to be the project stream, which I'm also excited about. And Wednesday is going to be coloring with India Inks. All right, y'all. So stick around. I'll be back in 5 minutes. If you enjoyed this content, hit the subscribe button. Hit the like button. They both help the stream. And would be greatly appreciated. And with that said, y'all, I'll see you in a few. Thank you.